Hello, this is Sky Moore. This segment is on letters of credit. What is a letter of credit? Letter of credit always involves three parties. It involves what we call the customer, who owes money to somebody, and let's call the somebody beneficiary. Below the customer is the customer's bank, and that is what we call the issuing bank. And how a letter of credit works is the beneficiary says, I don't really trust you, customer, to pay me, so I would like a contract between me and your issuing bank agreeing to pay me directly. And that contractual obligation from the bank to the beneficiary is called a letter of credit. And a letter of credit comes in two different flavors, either a standby letter of credit or a payment letter of credit. A standby letter of credit, issuing bank says, I hereby agree that if customer doesn't pay you, beneficiary, then I agree to pay you. I am standing by, waiting to see if customer defaults on the payment to you. And if they pay you, then I'm out of the picture. In general, you don't want a standby letter of credit for two reasons. One is that anytime you have a letter of credit, you can guarantee that the issuing bank will say to customer, please give me the full amount of money that I can hold in my account to secure you, customer's obligation to pay me, issuing bank, in case I have to pay, which means customer will have to put in the full amount of the funding with the issuing bank and may not have the funds left over to pay the beneficiary directly. So when the time comes to make payment, customer says, I don't have the money. Beneficiary says, you have defaulted and I'm terminating the contract. And that's not a happy day. So that's one reason for a customer not to want a standby letter of credit. The other reason that you might not want it, if you're representing beneficiary, is that maybe the customer does pay you directly, so you don't have a letter of credit. Letter of credit falls away, but then, for whatever reason later on, customer declares bankruptcy, and as we'll learn in a separate segment on bankruptcy, customer says, I want my money back. And beneficiary may have to pay it back in the bankruptcy and is now left without a claim against the letter of credit, unless beneficiary was clever and left the letter of credit in place for a while. Generally, that's 90 days. And so it just adds complexity. The other kind of letter of credit is a payment letter of credit, and that's when the time comes to make payment. It's just the beneficiary goes to the issuing bank and says, pay me. And the customer is at that point out of the picture, and the payment is just directly between the issuing bank and the beneficiary. In most cases, what you want is just a payment letter of credit. Now, how does the letter of credit work? Letter of credit works is you pre-agree in advance that in order to get paid, the beneficiary has to show up with drawdown documents. And you agree in advance what those drawdown documents look like. And the key is that the issuing bank doesn't care what those documents say. Those documents could say, the moon is made of green cheese. Issuing bank simply will take the drawdown documents when the time comes, beneficiary shows up with the documents signed, and the issuing bank will make sure that they match the original agreement that was agreed to. They will hold it up effectively to the light and just make sure that the lettering is the same. And as long as the documents match and they're signed, the issuing bank is then obligated to make payment to the beneficiary within a certain period of time. Usually it's between 3 and 5 days. And that's, as far as the issuing bank is, the end of the story. Now, customer cares very much what those drawdown documents say. The customer will want protection that the documents actually do what they're supposed to do. For example, what if the document says the film has been delivered, signed by the beneficiary, but in fact the film has not been delivered, right? So what does customer do? And the answer is that if those documents are inaccurate, then the customer gets to run down to court and bring an injunction to stop payment on the letter of credit, and the only grounds that they can do this for is fraud. So the key document in all letters of credit is the drawdown document. The good news and the bad news from the customer's perspective is the customer doesn't have to pay the beneficiary until the conditions are met, as opposed to having to pay a deposit in advance, for example. That's the good news. The bad news is money will have to be placed with the issuing bank, and so that money will be out of reach of the customer in the interim until delivery occurs. Okay? But if I want to warn you on anything of letters of credit, it's focus on that drawdown document, because that's where the rubber meets the road. All right? This is Sky Moore tuning off on this segment. Hope you join me for the next one.